Hey there, it's Trish from Dish Kitty Studio, and I had a request recently. Someone was interested in having me talk about. Oh, here's my cat, Buffy. Her bed is right here underneath the camera tripod, and she can't stand me sitting here without petting her. Anyway, I got a request. Someone was interested in looking at my fountain pen collection. So I thought I would just kind of talk about the pens that I have. Sorry, let me try to get rid of her. I thought I'd talk about the pens that I have and show them to you, and then also my inks and things like that. Buffy Louise, come here. Say hello. Hi, everybody. All right, go on, kid. All right, sorry about that. Okay, this is a very fancy pen case. I'm sure you'll recognize it as neoprene. It's a glasses case that I bought at the Dollar Tree. So very fancy and quite, expensive. I use this I tuck this into one of the pockets of my art bag, and it works perfectly for me. I know there's a lot of really expensive ones out there and leather and all different kinds of things, but this works really great for me, and for a dollar I can't really complain too much. So let me show you what I've gotten here. These are the ones that I use probably the most often. This one is one of my favorites. This is a Lamy Joy. I don't know if you can tell, but the end of it kind of gets like skinnier at the end. It's a great pen. This is my first and only Lamy pen. I know they make some other really, really popular, the All-Star, the Safari. This is the Joy. It has a stub nib, which stub nibs are probably my favorite. This one I always keep. This is my go-to for sketching, so I always keep this one. Here, let me zoom in a little bit. I always keep this one with the same ink inked up, which is this bottle right here. This is Noodler's Heart of Darkness. It's a very nice dark black ink. It's a little bit juicy. It's to me, it's perfect for sketching. And it's water resistant. I would not say it's waterproof. It's water resistant, but I do use it with watercolors, and I don't mind that it bleeds a tiny bit. One of the reasons I love it so much, if you are familiar with fountain pens at all, you'll know that a stub nib it's got a flat tip. Let me hold this up and you can maybe see. This is a shorter, this one's got a small stub, but so you can make nice thick strokes with it. The other reason I love this pen so much is because if you turn it upside down so that you're writing with it backwards, you can get a pretty consistent line. It's not as good, but it's much thinner. So this pen to me is great because I can get a nice thick line, and then I can turn it upside down and get a much smaller line if I want a little bit more detail. But yeah, this is my go-to for drawing and sketching. This is it with the Noodler's Heart of Darkness. This is my drawing pen, and I use it a lot to ink my drawings too. All right, next up, I'll show you these two together because they're the same pen. These are the Platinum Preppy pens. They come in They come in a ton of different colors. I have the pink and the blue here. I don't know if you can even get a converter. I don't know if you can even get a converter for these or not. I don't have one. What I do is I just clean out my, I just keep rinsing out the cartridges and refilling them. This one you can see has lime green ink in it, which I'm not a huge fan of. It's really more of a highlighter ink, so it's hard to see your writing with it. This one is the pink. These are both the 05 size, which I think is maybe like a medium. I'm not sure. But the thing I love about these is they have the colored tips. I believe they don't make them anymore with the colored nibs, which is a real drag because I was gonna replace this one. I don't know if you can see, but what's going on with my focus here? Why won't it focus? My blue one, it's kind of scratched off a little bit at the very tip, and you can see it's gotten silver there. But these are really, really inexpensive. I want to say $5 or less for sure. And honestly, I think the nibs are great. These are super reliable writers. They write really, really nicely every time. I'm not going to show you the lime green because it's very hard to read, but I will show you this one. This one is, I'm trying to think what color it's got in it. Oh, it's got, I filled it with one of my bottle inks, which is this one right here. This is Levenger Cocoa. This was a bottle of ink that was actually given to me by my father-in-law. And I actually like it. I love brown. I enjoy brown inks. So you can see this is a very, it's not a hard starter. It writes really consistently. I love these. I think these preppies are just a great value. I really do. I like them. I intend to get more of them. So, great pens for the price. This one is a Jinhao. I believe it's the Jinhao 159. It's got a really pretty nib. It's got, come on, zoom in, guy. What's your deal? Not sure why. Yeah, that's a little better. Probably just too much glare. It's got a really pretty nib with a lot of designs on it. I think this is a bigger nib. I don't usually like the fine and extra fine and all that kind of stuff, so I usually end up going for a heavier line. I'll show you this one. I can't remember what ink is in here either. Oh yes, okay. This is Noodler's Apache Sunset, which is a beautiful ink, and it's got some gorgeous shading. Oops, gosh, I'm off camera. Guys, I'm really bad at this. Okay. It's got some gorgeous shading you can get from it. It's so pretty. It's almost from like a gold into like a really nice deep orange. This is a pretty nice pen. It's not amazing, but it's inexpensive. I think this pen is maybe $12, I would guess, something like that. It's in that ballpark. It's not very much. And this does come in a bunch of different colors. I know it's white. There's a lime green. There's several different ones. But it's a good pen for the price, for sure. It's very large. Like, look at the difference in the size of the pen. And it's got quite a bit of weight to it. So if you're someone that writes a lot, like if you do a lot of writing, I don't know if it would be the best pen for you. This one is it's a Vanishing Point, which this is definitely the most expensive pen that I have. And this one is a Namiki, which is who used to make the Vanishing Point, but then they were bought out or something by Pilot, and now Pilot makes the Vanishing Point. But this is the old school. It says Namiki on the front right here. I don't know if you can see it right where my fingers are. Probably not because of this glare. And it's got a plastic barrel, but it's a super nice pen, and it writes amazingly. This was a gift from my father-in-law. And I have, the ink I have in here right now is Diamine Passion Red, which I have a bottle of also. And this pen just writes beautifully. And I like this ink a lot too. I do have, like I said, I have a bottle of it right here. Passion Red. I don't have a ton of bottled inks, but the ones I have I use a lot, obviously. That's why I have them in bottles. These are the pens that I use the most. Another reason that I love the preppies is because it's so much fun to just, I can just rinse out the cartridge, let it dry, and then put different ink in it, and I can use different crazy colors, and I'm not quite so... They're just more fun. They just seem so flexible and easy to use. I have a couple... Let's see, what do I have? This is how I store my pens, by the way, when I'm not using them. This is a plastic, you know, what do you call it? It's got like the little juice things, you know, that you like the little tubs that you can add to water. And I have one for... This is another Jinhao. I have two of them. It's a Jinhao, I want to say, X750 or something like that. Neither of these, I have two of the same. Neither are inked up. Again, they have a very pretty nib. And they are so... Look how sparkly they are. It's like... They're beautiful. They're so pretty. They have a nice weight. They're like... They feel like they're acrylic or something like that. I'm not sure. But they're nice pens. The nibs on them are not the greatest. I've heard that a lot of people buy the pen because it's a nice pen and then switch it out for a different nib, which I may end up doing, but I don't really have the need at the moment because I have plenty of pens. This is just a spare cartridge. Yeah, that's why these things work out really nicely because I can keep all my stuff separate. These are... some cartridge inks, Pelican Brilliant Green, that are for these pens. They also fit my other Jinhao. So I just keep, this basically has all my Jinhao stuff. So when I'm not using my orange 159, I keep that in this little tub as well. Let's see what else I got here. Here is my Vanishing Point box. I have them all labeled. These all have, see it says VP. This is just my paperwork for the VP. Like I said, that's a pretty expensive pen. I want to say to buy it right now, probably $120 for a new one. And this one's like vintage from the 80s, so I have no idea how much that would even go for. These are just a couple of spare converters I have for it. This is cartridges for it, Namiki Blue Black. And what else do I have here? Here's a... empty cartridge just in case I want to refill it, and here's even another converter. So it's kind of, this is, I mean, I know it's kind of like cheesy, but it's actually these little things work out perfectly for me for all my little bits and everything. And then I don't like pick up, you know, before I had different cartridges and I'd be like, oh crap, which pen are these for and stuff like that. Which one do they fit? But now I kind of have it all together. This is for my preppies. So here's the extra inks I got with them. I've got extra blue cartridges and extra pink. So I keep those in my little preppy box. For my Lamy Joy, I have the paperwork, like the little paper that came with it. This is just a little bag that holds the converter, which is in the pen right now. But the reason I kept it is so that I can see, you know, what kind of converter it is in case I need to buy a new one. And then this is just a Lamy cartridge. So, that's my Lamy stuff. Here is another pen I have that's not inked up right now. It's another stub nib. And this is the Pilot Plumix. It's like super weird shape, and you see the cap's got these like little fins on it, and this is like kind of got a weird like barrel on it. This is a nice pen though, and this one's very inexpensive too. I want to say maybe like $8. This is the other stub nib pen that I have. It's another really short stub nib. They have some that are much wider, and I think I'd like to eventually try one of those, but. So this is the Plumix. It's not inked up right now, but this is also a nice pen. It just doesn't seem like I have my Lamy Joy, which is my other stub nib, pretty much 24/7 it's inked up with the Noodler's Heart of Darkness. So I don't see really much of a need to have two unless I really want some, you know, a stub nib in a different color. This came with my bottle of Heart of Darkness. It's a Noodler's Charlie pen. This one actually comes free with that bottle of ink, and I have never inked it up, to be honest. It's an eyedropper pen, which means it doesn't use a cartridge or a converter. You actually just fill the barrel of the pen with ink. Honestly, I bought it because I really wanted the ink. It's got a beautiful cap, though. I don't know if you can see the cool colors on it, but it's very pretty. You know, I bought the ink because I wanted the ink, and I didn't really care so much about the pen, and I haven't ever tried an eyedropper, and I just wasn't. I've had it for, I don't know, a few months, and I've just never gotten around to really messing with it. So, that's it for pens that I have. I thought I would kind of show you some of the different inks and things that I have. You saw my Heart of Darkness. I also have a small bottle of, this is Diamine Soft Mint, which is a very, it's a really pretty color. I like it a lot. I was happy to get this smaller bottle though, because like when I bought the Passion Red from Diamine, I had to get the bigger bottle. And honestly, my goodness, it takes me forever to go through the ink. So, you know, I was happy to be able to get a smaller one. This is the Noodler's Apache Sunset that I showed you that was in my, it was inked up in my Jinhao 159. This one is Noodler's Habanero, where the Apache Sunset is a little bit more gold. This is much more of a very bright, deep orange. It's a really pretty color. I like both of these very much. Then I've got the Levenger Cocoa, which you saw, and I have another bottle of Levenger Amethyst. This was also a gift from my father-in-law. It's a very nice, pretty purple. These are just a couple of little pen sleeves that I stuck in here. They're just like velvet. They're very cheesy, but I thought, oh, these might be nice if I want to like throw one of my pens in my purse or something. I haven't used them yet. This is a really cool vintage ink bottle, like an inkwell, that I bought at a flea market. It's got a little slidey top here so you can stick your pen in or your converter or cartridge, whatever. I just thought it was really cool. It was only a few bucks, and I don't know, I just thought, oh, it's kind of cool, but I haven't used it. I cleaned it out really well and everything, made sure it was really clean, and but I haven't put any ink in it, but I do really like it. This is just a bunch of ink samples that I have. I use these a lot. I use a lot of samples because I like to try different colors. So, you know, I have just a ton of different stuff in here. Like, see, look at this bright yellow. I also have, like, yeah, right here, here's a bottle of white ink. Or a vial, I guess. So these are really fun. This, you can see right here, this is the Neon Lime, the one that I said my pen was inked up with right now. So I do use these quite a bit. I have some scented inks in here, a couple scented ones, and I have a couple of, actually several of the, you know, new shimmery, glittery inks are kind of all the rage. I've only inked a pen up with them once because they're it's very hard to get the shimmer stuff out, and I usually just honestly don't really want to mess with having to clean it out and worry about whether it. I had a real bad experience with my expensive Vanishing Point, the expensive one that was a gift. I put the wrong kind of ink in it, and it was a big tragedy, and I had to send it back and have it professionally cleaned, and it was a mess. So I'm pretty particular about the kinds of ink I use nowadays. The only other stuff I have in here is, like, I use this for fleshing out my pens when I clean it. I use this sometimes if I'm trying to, this is just like a little tall, skinny shot glass. If I'm trying to kind of soak something, I'll put a little bit of pen flush. This is pen cleaner. I'll put a little bit of pen cleaner and water or something and let something soak in there, like a nib or whatever it is. And that's it. That's my fountain pen story. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions about fountain pens, just about everything I have here, certainly all my pens except for the Vanishing Point, which I said was a gift. I buy all my stuff from Goulet Pens. It's GouletPens.com. I'll put a link down below. I'm not affiliated with them at all, but I think they're a great company. If you're interested in fountain pens, they're a great resource to learn more, and they have an amazing selection. All of these sample bottles came from them, and they have a million more. I think they have hundreds upon hundreds of colors of inks for you to try and play with. So if you have questions about fountain pens, you you know, shoot me a comment, and I'll try my best to answer them. I'm not an expert by any means, but you know, I've been mucking around with fountain pens for a couple of years now, so I'll help you if I can. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you again soon. Thanks.